Hello everyone. So during our live session, we had started the second chapter of your book, It So Happened, that is Children at Work. And I have told you about the characters of the story, as well as I have told you about the main character also. There are two characters in the story. First one is Velu, and the second one, we yet to know about her actually. Second one is Jaya, a little girl. They both children are of almost same age. So I have told about Velu that he had run from his home. Why? Because his father used to beat him and snatch everything, snatch every money, whatever he and his sister used to earn for the survival. So basically he was from Chennai, but yes, he ran away from his home, and then he was standing on a railway station and just somewhere scared. Why? Because first time he was looking that much mass and that much gathering of people. So one thing is there, and second thing, he was hungry. Only some peanuts and jaggery he had taken, and just because of that he was feeling very hungry, tired, exhausted, and as well as he was somewhere scared also because of the environment of the railway station. But suddenly a voice came from behind, and she was calling Velu, who was the voice of the same girl, Jaya. And when Velu turned, that time he saw that a same age girl is standing in front of him, and he was wearing a banyan, as she was looking like a poor girl, and her hair were totally stiffy, as it was not combed for a longer time, as well as there were some questions from Jaya's side. So at first sight only she recognized that the boy had run away from his home, and she asked the same question also, and that Velu, he was totally surprised that how did she know that. Then what happened, that Velu started observing the girl, and he observed that the girl was having a sack on her shoulders, and she was packing the rags. So who was she? Actually, she was a rag picker. She used to collect the rags and the disposable cups and plates from the railway station, and means that work she was doing for her survival. So this was the work of Jaya. So students, this much whatever we had covered during the live session, it was all about your first comprehension. Now further in this session we'll continue with our second comprehension of the same chapter. So as I have told you, that Jaya started talking herself, and further she sat with Velu only, and then she started talking. Then Velu was able to observe that she was a poor girl and doing work for her survival only. Then what happened in the second one I am reading, he caught up with the girl as she was leaving the station. When they got to the road, Velu found the vehicles kept coming and never stopped for anyone. Yes, that time he was on the road. He caught up with the road because Jaya also asked the boy that you can come with me if you are alone here. Nobody is there to take care of you. And one thing is there, he was stranger. Velu was stranger there. So Jaya said, okay, you can come along with me. I will just arrange some work for you also. Then Velu caught up with Jaya and he went with Jaya. And as they reached there on the road, Velu saw many of the vehicles of heavy traffic used to be there in the cities. And this view was also new to Velu. Then what happened? Smoke and dust flew at him from all sides, making his head spin. Spin means hailing. Spin means moving continuously. So it was spinning because there was much of the pollution because of the vehicles and traffic. So they had to wait for a long time before they could find a gap to run through. So you know that in cities heavy traffic used to be there. So for crossing the road, almost they have taken much time. Velu kept hesitating. Yes, Velu was hesitating in crossing the road because much traffic was there and He was very new to the place. And then the girl finally dragged him to the other side. She almost pulled Velu to the other side as he was hesitating to cross the road. "What do you think you are doing, grazing cow? If you stand around in the middle of the road like that, you will be chutney." So it was, these were Jaya's word only. And she said to Velu that if you will just stand like this and you will hesitate to cross the road fastly, so definitely you will become a chutney there only. Means the vehicles will be just squeeze you on the road. Velu's heart was still beating fast because he was just an 11-year-old child and coming from a rural area and facing such kinds of traffic first time, so his heart was continuously beating fast. And one thing what Jaya has told Velu, grazing cows, they used to sit in the middle of the road only, and when they start eating, so it's hard to push them aside. So Velu was also standing there in between the road, so that's why Jaya was calling him grazing cows. Now further what happened, they walked along the side of the road under some huge signboards. So as they crossed the roads, so there was a huge signboard there on the other side of the road. Velu looked up at the pictures, banyans, car tires, pens, women holding a box. So many kinds of holdings, big holdings were there on that roadside, and the writing was all in English. And whatever was written there, that was in English only. So he didn't know what it meant, but Velu, he didn't know English. So it was difficult for him to understand what was written there on the holdings. The girl turned onto a wide bridge and walked up. Velu stopped and peeped over the railing. Then after the road, they reached to a breeze. A wide bridge was there, and there also traffic was going on. And they were walking side by side on the breeze. Then Velu stopped and peeped. Peep means Velu was just looking like this, as he was searching something. He was peeping out where the railing was there of the breeze. Under him, the road ran into the city. In the distance, he could see huge buildings and towers and more roads. Why he was peeping down? Because new place was there. Many of the big roads are there. Huge towers and buildings are there. So these all things were new to a boy actually, a child actually. So see that big building with the wall around it. If you are not careful, you will soon be counting bars there. The girl grinned and pointed at a huge building. So a huge building was there in front of them. So the girl was pointing towards the building and she is saying, see that huge building. And if you will just stay here only, then definitely you will have to go in that huge building and you will count the bars there. Bars, you know, it was a cell, that was a police station. And she was saying that if you will stay here only, you will not move from here. So definitely soon you will count the bars there in that building. Velu squinted and read the Tamil sign, Central Jail. So in Tamil language, there was written Central Jail. So Velu, because he was belonging to Tamil area, so he recognized the sign and he read Central Jail. Why? I haven't done anything wrong. So he understood actually what she is trying to say. So he said that why will I be there, because I hadn't do anything wrong. You don't know how to do anything, just don't get caught, that's all. So this was the reply of Jaya, that you don't need to be caught there. I'm not saying that you will be there, but you will stand here, so definitely you will be in that building. What does she mean? Velu wondered, but Velu didn't understand, because there are rules and regulations everywhere. In cities somewhere regulations are there different, and in rural area somewhere rules are different. So meanwhile, the girl was already heading down the bridge with the sack off her shoulder. What was in it? He had seen her putting plastic cups into it at the station. But as they both were walking, Jaya was continued with her work. She was still picking up the rags, picking up the cups and plates from the railway stations and all around. And she was just putting everything that in the sack. What are you carrying in that bag? Now, out of curiosity, Velu is asking, why are you carrying these things in the bags? Things, bottles, paper. Velu wondered what she was going to do with them, but he felt shy to ask any more questions. So, still Velu was not actually understood why she is pulling that much things and waste things. It was still morning, but the sun blasted down on the tar and Velu's bare feet burned. Tar, you understand, tar here means road. The road is made up of tar. So they are using here this word, the charcoal which we used to spread on the roads. So here tar is used. So it was still morning, but sun has blasted. So already the road was too hot and Velu's bare foot, they were burning. It was not like walking on a mud road, but in the village there used to be mud road. It used to be somewhere colder than the roads. He was soaked with sweat. The Velu was sweating. He tried hard to walk in the shade and keep up with the girl at the same time. But he was just continuing running with the girl. She walked really fast, and how far away was the food? Then she was continuously running with the girl because she promised that she will arrange something for Velu, and in a hope of food because he was hungry. So he was continuously running with the girl. After almost an hour of walking, they stopped in front of a big building. So at least their destination came there. They stopped in front of a building, Shri Raj Rajeshwari Prasanna Kalyan Mandapam. So it was written there. You may see in your books whatever words are given. Read Velu slowly. That was also in Tamil. So Velu had read that easily. A sign with letters made of flowers. A groom, J.V. Vinayagan, Bride Rani. So in floral design, some names were written there. And a building was there. It was beautifully decorated. And Velu stared at the big cars parked outside. And outside the building, there are many cars were parked there. One of the cars had a flower garland. Garland, you understand, a kind of circle of the flowers. So it was there, roses tapped onto it. Like we used to decorate the cars and vehicles during some marriage. So it was the same sight. The girl looked around, pulled one off quickly and stuck it in her hair. So because she was a girl, so she picked one of the flower from a car and then she hide it in the hair only. So come on, she said. Are we going to eat here? Asked Velu, looking at a huge hall and the people inside. Velu was surprised because the girl was too poor. He himself was not proper. So he was thinking, are we going to eat here in this big building? So he was totally surprised to see that. Hopes, she said, the girl shaking her thumb under his nose, and she led him behind the hall. So as Velu asked that, the girl led Velu behind the hall, not in that building, but behind that hall only. And after that, there was a big garbage bin overflowed with rubbish. And there was a big garbage bin, and in that garbage bin, that was full of rubbish. So why do you think that girl, he just led Velu to that side? Because now they both poor children, they will search for the leftover food. Because the party was going on, marriage was there, so party was going on there. So whatever leftover food will be there, they will have to eat that much only. So a cloud of flies buzzed around that. So see what kind of a condition will be there. But they, for the survival, they had to eat that also. So these all are conditions of the person. But still, see the zeal of living, that they used to do work. So children also used to do work. And they want to live, they want to survive despite of many of the problems. So flies were there, they have to pick the things from the garbage bin, and then like that only they will have to fill their stomach. So it's a very hard thing for them. Apart from that, no one is there who will just take care of their education, who will just provide them a good education and provide them everything whatever a child needs. But still, such students somewhere, if they get a small opportunity, they actually get rise. They rise in their life. Brilliant students, because brilliant children they used to be, those who can work so harder without parents and than they used to live also. So the same thing is there. So Velu was shocked. And are we going to eat their leftovers? He understood. So he was saying, no, I am not going to eat this. It was too rubbish. Everything is there. Totally rubbish was there. Dustbin was that. So actually he was feeling like vomiting. Come on, hero, eat it. You think I like it? I told you I will find you something to eat. Don't think I have money to buy food for you. You would better eat what you get until you have your own money. So see the girl, how he just trying to put the boy to be on the track. She is saying that you will have to eat this only if you want to survive. Whenever you will work, you will earn something for you. So definitely that time you can buy for yourself whatever you want. But for now, as I promised you, you will have to take things from here only. So Velu, first of all, he was hesitated somewhere, but later, because he was totally empty stomach, so he put a banana. Jaya actually had given to him, and then he just taken that also from there. Then it's too early, they have only eaten tiffin. If you are still hungry, you have to wait for them to finish lunch. So Jaya, as she used to go on such places frequently and she knows about that, then she said they have only completed just breakfast only. If you want to eat more, we will wait for their lunch also, and whenever they will finish that, they will throw the leftover and we will survive on that only. You can wait if you want. So students, this was the second comprehension. I'm not going actually word to word, otherwise it will be going too long. Talking about your third comprehension, what will be there, that we will finish in our next video or in live lecture, that you will come to know about that, you will get the notification about it. Here, this video I am stopping here only. So this was all about Velu and Jaya. So what kind of children they used to be, how they used to survive, you understood. But still they gave a kind of lesson to the society, to other children, that we should love our life. We should work harder for the survival, whether whatever conditions used to be there. Many of the cases are coming nowadays. You also used to listen that even children, college students, school students, just because of the some results and something like, they are dying, they are committing suicide. And without thinking that they have a family, those who have provided them everything. But such kind of children also used to be there. Those who want to live, if anyone will give them a chance to live, definitely they will grow better than us, we can say. So yes, we will complete this chapter in our next session. I'm ending this here only. Thank you.